From the conservatory course in Palm Coast, Florida, the final round of the Gensermeyer Classic, Michael Lentzen leading after 54 holes looking for his first PGA Tour win. John Houston and others would factor as well, but the weather was the big story, a lengthy three-hour rain delay during the middle part of the day before they could get back out on the course, and George McNeil, as soon as he did, he would watch that one drop for birdie at 18. It would be three closing birdies for McNeil to move to 6 under par. How would he factor in this? Nicklaus Thompson looking for his first PGA Tour win, dropping it right in over the top of the flag at 18, and another player to move to 6 under par. Ken Duke at the closing hole. He's just outside of the top 30 on the money list, hoping to make it to the United States Open and the Masters next year. That is a beautiful pitch into the 18 green and a birdie to also move to 6 under. Vaughn Taylor has a chance to break this large group up for birdie to move to 7 under at 18. And it hangs on that right edge. He could not convert. So Taylor remains at 6 under. Meanwhile, Ryan Palmer, who had moved to 8 under par before arriving at number 10, his ball moved. The wind so severe that he addressed the ball. PGA Tour official comes in, says, we have to assess a one-shot penalty. He bogeys the 10th, and he let it get to him a little bit because he double bogeyed 11. But when he arrived at 18, he hit his best shot of the day. Just under the green at 18, and he would set up a putt of just inside 10 feet for the win. Seven players at 6 under par. We need one to break out of this logjam, and Ryan Palmer does it. A birdie at 18. 7 under wins the Gensermeyer Classic.